The implications of sea level rise and why we need to be aware of it is simply because it is the avalanche that's coming. What it's going to do is it's going to dramatically reconfigure the coastlines. It's going to change the beaches, likely erode them away substantially. Your kids, as grandparents, when they come here to La Jolla Shores to hang out with their grandkids, will not recognize this place. My name is Falk Feddersen, and I am a professor of oceanography here at Scripps Institution of Oceanography. I basically study the waves, the currents, and the way that sand gets moved around from the top of the beach all the way out to many hundreds of yards offshore. How this relates to sea level rise is that many beaches are set up in an equilibrium state. So they like the sort of configuration they're in. But when you have sea level rise and when you have increasing storms, that's going to affect this equilibrium state of the beaches. It's going to lead to a lot of erosion, and it's going to lead to a lot of change to the coastlines. Sea level rise is not going to only impact the open coast. And so if a place like in Mission Beach in San Diego basically becomes flooded, then all those businesses and the homeowners and the property values there will go to zero, and people will suffer dramatic economic losses, which will be on the order of basically a permanent Hurricane Sandy hitting New York. The other sorts of impacts are on wetlands and on ecosystems and on all the creatures that inhabit the coastal zones, from the rocky intertidal down over there to all the wetlands and marshes inside estuaries down in like the Tijuana River estuary, for example. And as a society, in terms of adaptation, we have to start making the decisions of, when we're losing a beach, do we want to just keep on putting new sand on the beach and then having that sand erode? And is the cost of doing that worth it in terms of the pleasure that society is getting from the beach? Or is it better to say, you know what, like maybe we need to break down these seawalls and maybe we need to erode further back and then we can get natural sand again coming in from the cliffs and the dunes.